into the corner, but I couldn't, you know, my mum used to do it so tight, I couldn't move my forehead. And my eyes, you know, it's like painful. But then the next day when I took them off, I got this big afro that would blow in the wind, and I was so proud.
I also had this with money.
At school, I always remember people touching it, people pointing at it. A lot of the time, my mum didn't have time to do my hair, so I'd just sort of turn up at school with this big, wild, uncontrollable afro. People would laugh, people would point.
Actually, I had both, but with different mothers and as different people in different lives. So disregard everything I've just said. I've already forgotten it. Now, in a minute, I'm going to show you all some photographs. Now, this is me at my school sports day. Now, please note the Christmas jumper, which was odd because it was July, but Mummy was always ahead of the game. She was the first person to have a George Foreman grill, the first person to have a mixed race child. The only person in the village to have a mixed-race child, in fact. Mummy was Aquarius, very forward-thinking. Now, in the photograph, you can see I'm slightly sweaty. It's because I've had a rather punishing game of lacrosse. Even so, I'm in much better shape than my physical education teacher, Mr. McDonald, who, as you can see, is very out of condition. Actually, he retired shortly after that photograph was taken, which was a blessing in disguise, because his halitosis was getting impossible to be with. I am so pleased you're all here tonight with your very interesting varieties of hairstyles. I do hope you enjoy the show, and my performance in particular, which you will find is exemplary. And remember, I am here for you all. Always. Always. Laters.
My earliest memories of hair, really, would have been at school. But at high school, I remember I had to wet my hair every day because it was just so thick. I couldn't get an afro comb for it. A wooden comb, I'd broken so many of these wooden ones, these wooden plasticky ones, so many. I had to only use the wire ones, the metal ones, which I hated. I didn't really like those.
The immediate family, I would have been the darkest female. And I think that might have had an influence. There was a mixed race look of hair, and I didn't have it.
Okay, to be honest, being the one blessed with good hair is hard work. I mean, look, for your information, I'm not a golden retriever. I'm not an orange rebel, and I'm not Scary Spice.
I said your big and curls. I said your big curls are so beautiful. If you say so. Whatever. And will you stop using my perfume? It's dead expensive and there's hardly any left of it.
I'm not. Hey, aren't they supposed to be about 66 or something now? Just about drawing their pension and that.
Oh, don't ask me. I clearly don't know what I'm talking about.
Kitten, please, I'm dying here.
All right. Do you want milk?
Yes, please.
Well, what's your last name?
Sugar helps my nerves.
It's a hen's night. It's kitten's hen night. You should be happy, clappy.
I am happy.
Well, be happy, clappy then. Read your Bible or something. What's this fizzy meat stuff? Is that a cup up?
It's tea.
No, it's dishwater is what it is. You should know by now. Since our sister is a strong woman, she likes some strong.
Well, I make great tea. Ryan says so. And he loves my eggs Benedict.
Ooh, I bet he does.
Sister!
Oh, so what? You can cook now. 5 years ago, you couldn't boil an egg.
That was 5 years ago. A lot's changed since then, sister.
If you'd bothered to stay around, you'd know that.
Shut it, Angela.
The Lord is my rock. Where are you taking me?
To the trial.
In him will I trust. He is my shield and the horn of salvation, my high tower and my refuge, my saviour. The Lord saves me from violence. Samuel 2, chapter 22, verse...
I thought Angela, I thought Emma was a Rasta.
No, Rasta was the last one. She's born again now.
Oi, Angela. Angela! Oi, Angela!
I answer to that name no longer. Angela no more. Anna is here.
She's born again.
Colossians chapter 3, verse 15. And may the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which indeed you are called in one body. And may you be thankful.
Look, it's just how she calms herself down. Don't worry about it.
Yeah. Is she okay now? You know?
Yes, of course.
Because well, you know I would have come back earlier if she'd have needed me to. Does she need me to come back?
Look, yes, of course we needed you, sister. Did you miss me? Mm-hmm. Yeah. We missed you, sister.
Good.
Because I'm back now.
So it's all good, yes?
Yeah, yeah.
Sister, look at me.
How can I be anything but good?
You are gorgeous, kitten. You always have been.
This place is gorgeous.
Yeah, it should be. Cost me a bloody fortune.
And I love that patio bit up the back.
I've blown all of my redundancy in this place.
All of it, yeah.
Every last Hong Kong dollar.
What happens if it doesn't work out?
No, it will. It has to.
Well, you can go bankrupt.
Oh, wait, man. This place is going to be a business.
It's a business.
Yeah, it's going to be the best Afro hairdressers this side of the M25.
It's going to be the only Afro hairdressers this side of the M25.
Look, people won't need to go all the way up to London anymore to get their hair cut like we had to do when we were growing up.
There's still no black people around here, sister. Where are you going to get customers from?
Emma, come here. Just come here.
What are you going to do to me?
Nothing. Six.
Here.
Since we opened last Saturday, I've had 56 customers in here. Some white, some black. Yesterday, Emma, I had a lovely old mixed race lady of about 17. Do you know what she said to me?
I'm sure you're going to tell.
I used to go to the hairdressers, and they would say to me, oh, no, we don't do your sort of hair, it's too difficult.
When I was growing up in Kerri and Eastbourne, I used to think that my colour was the same as the stuff that used to go down the toilet.
When I was a child, mostly women, would come along and stroke my hair.
Try to feel proud of yourself for who you are, and listen to those people who want to encourage you to feel good about yourself, and also to go to other places if you can, like to the nearest sort of cities where there are hair products and sort of hair dressers, hair salons that can advise you about what to do with your hair, so that at least you can find ways of to sort of try not to feel too isolated. I think it's really important. Be proud.
That nice old lady cried after I gave her a haircut. And she thanked me for making her feel comfortable about coming into wear hairdressers in her hometown for the first time ever. And that's what I'm doing with the crowd. I'm going to like that old lady, so I can make a difference.
Always
I mean, I'm finally doing something that I believe in. So is that okay? Is it?
My hair didn't give me any problems when I was growing up here.
Please. remember you coming home crying your eyes out because the blondies wouldn't have you in their wash and go there.
I didn't.
What? You poured a bottle of bleach on your head and went bright orange and dropped out. Mum had to come over the hospital and cry for a week.
Did not!
Did not! You wouldn't get out of bed! And you used to wear a swimming hat and bed at night to try and straighten
your head. Oh. Thief cometh but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and that they might have it abundantly.
Amen.
John, verse 10, chapter 10.
Mm-hmm. Whatever.
So, are you going to do my hair then? Or what?
What you need is some nice funky dreads. Loosen you up a bit.
No way! I want it relaxed. I want Oprah Winfrey.
Oh, funky dreads.
Oprah Winfrey.
You know, I bet Aaron would love to see his mum with some funky dreads with me.
Yeah.
You'll be the coolest mum at the wedding, you'll be, won't you? Hey. Aaron is coming to the wedding, isn't he?
He's very busy with work.
I've come all the way from Hong Kong. You better bloody be there.
Oprah Winfrey.
It's my hen party. I should get to decide.
Well, not Oprah Winfrey.
Any hairstyle we wanted. Your treat, remember? Sister? Hello?
Yes, well,
relax. It always looks so nice and shiny.
Bloody old Ken, she's not floor polish.
Oh.
Yes, relax. It's got to be relaxed.
Man, all that chemical and shit in your scalp. You don't want that.
I do.
But what's wrong with funky dreads?
I want neat and tidy.
Funky dreads are neat and tidy.
I want neat and tidy.
You want your head examined.
Why are you so horrible to me?
Emma, you don't need anyone else's approval. You are beautiful just how you are.
No, I'm not.
You are beautiful, stupid cat.
Forgotten how lovely this hair is. Really soft, really curly. And I've decided I'd had enough of the weave thing. I wanted my hair locks ages ago. Growing locks, he told me, is also a lesson about patience. And I was a very patient person in those days. That it's a lesson in patience. I used to draw little pictures of little faces with squiggly hair like that. Lock, shoulder length squiggly hair. And then every couple of months I'll go to a salon and get it loved.
You are beautiful, Emma. Hey, love yourself. I don't mean like that. I mean love yourself.
I love myself. I think I'm gorgeous.
That's not what I mean.
Sister, we made you this. Sorry, it got a bit crumpled.
Oh my God!
I made the S in sister and half the T.
We thought you could hang it up in the shop tonight.
This is you coming home is the best wedding present I could ever have, sister.
Yeah, you are.
Oh, guys, I don't know what to say.
Just say nothing for a change.
Yeah, okay. Put it up in there.
I still want it relaxed though.
People used to point out my hair and say it was like a Brillo pad, and I'd have strangers coming up to me like on the bus or if I was standing at a bus stop and just walk past, touch my hair and then say something to each other like, yeah, I told you, it's like a Brillo pad, you know. And I used to get people touching my hair without, you know, asking me even.
No respect.
Yeah, no respect, and I felt quite invaded actually by that, and I hated that.
You still haircuts?
I've had perms, I've had extensions.
I've got funky dreads, well, they're locks on the top of my head.
Everyone's different. Different shaped heads.
I can comb it the way I want to. Put my little flips in there.
It's a red. It's not as bright as I usually have it.
And at the moment, I'm into twists. which I quite enjoy having.
No hair at the back, no hair at the sides.
Tottenham's my home, so I love it.
I'm walking down the street, I'm bouncing down the street with my locks, so I lose.
I love my locks. I feel so good.
I cherish my locks.
I just feel good about myself.
Bouncing to soul to
smoking soul. My weed.
I'm happy, I'm in London.
I love my dreads.
London. London belongs to me.
Oh, now I'm 16 years old. London belonged to me.
I didn't know I was black until I came to London.
I didn't know I was black until I came to London.
I didn't even know I was black until I came to London, really.
You didn't know you were black?
No! I came from the sticks in Wiltshire. There were no other coloured people around for miles.
Coloured.
No other coloured people around.
Do you say coloured?
Well, I say coloured.
Yeah, you shouldn't say coloured.
I say coloured.
You need my salon. You need me.
No, my first day at middle school. I was only there for 1 year. Having to fight with two guys, called me a black this and a black that. They're talking about how to fight them both off. But I didn't even know I was black until I came to London.
That's right.
So
right here, I'll get that flight.
See
there?
Right. Okay. Oh. Oh, now, have you been doing your breathing exercises, Susie?
Oh, yes.
Excellent.
She didn't know she was
coloured
till she left Wiltshire. Oh my days.
Well, I had this black bottom and I had no idea where it came from.
Yes. Music?
Ooh, yes, why not?
Hey, fatty bum. The sweet sugar dumpling. Hey, fatty bum. Let me get you something. Don't mean to look like
keep still. They used to hit me there with the comb.
My mum used to wash it and make the and actually wash my hair like she's washing clothes.
Twisty, leave it under my house, my sister, to put a ribbon in it. Show her that nicely.
Ryan.
Sorry. It's all good. It's marvellous, isn't it?
Good to have you.
Anyway, Kitten, you still haven't told me how you want to do your hair.
The wedding's not for 3 weeks, there's loads of time.
Yeah, but you know how much I like to plan, you know how much I love doing your hair, and I'm so good at it as well.
And modest.
Yeah, exactly. Oh my god, and I've got a great petition lined up to do your hair.
No, I'm doing my own makeup.
Are you serious?
Yes. I don't trust anyone else to do it, I know exactly how I want it done.
But I can pay for you, babe.
No, it's fine, honestly.
Are you sure? Because I've already told her about the wedding and she's kept a slot free for
you. Sister, I told you I want to do my own makeup. Okay.
Maybe she could come and do us.
Yeah, good idea.
So we all have the same look.
Brilliant. So I still get her to come down and then she can do us and do touch-ups and then she's still around and gets to change your mind.
No, she's not touching
just
me up.
Just in case, Kitten, I just think it's going to be stressful, you know, you doing your own
sister,
makeup.
Sister, don't make it a big issue.
No, I'm not making
it's
it
a simple
issue.
Thing and you're turning it into
right,
a big
I'm not
thing.
Making it so
big.
Okay,
you can
do
it all
right, whatever you want.
Kitten, she can come and do us and it'll be fine. She'll spend loads of time with us. And as your sister.
Whoa, bloody chick! Did you
hear that?
No. I
haven't
solved any of
this here. Always do this, sister. Sure. It always has to be about you or what you want. It's my wedding, it's my special day.
listen,
I got up at 6 a.m. this morning to do my makeup because I wanted to look right. And it's all going wrong because of you picking fights and spoiling everything as usual.
We're fun, aren't we, sister?
Yeah, lovely.
Are you okay, Kitten?
Yes, I'm fine. Don't fuss. I hate it when you fuss.
Don't panic.
I'm not panicking, Anna, please. Here you go, babe. Have a drink.
I do like your hair, sister.
Oh, thanks, Simone.
Your hair and complexion are different from the others, aren't they, sister?
Yes.
Do you take after your father, sister?
No. Even Dad was lighter than me, a bit like a chestnut.
Oh, you mean conquer?
Yes. Only a bit dusty and shriveled. Yeah, he's like one of them shriveled old conquerors you find in your school bag months later. Because you brought it home but forgot to bash it to bits. In fact, he was the same colour as Nat King Cole, only a bit lighter and without the coffee-coloured voice. A bit sickly, really. Yeah, a bit Nat King Diet Coca-Cola, really.
But he was a really kind man, our dad.
Mm. And never there?
He was kind.
And quite depressed?
He was really, really kind.
You were his favourite, he spoiled you.
He was a great dad.
What? You were the little one that popped out at the end. The little unexpected blessing.
Oh, you mean the mistake?
No, we were the duty children. You were the lured child. You lured. Child, you.
How very moving. Obviously, your father was a very special man.
I'm the darkest in the family. Only Uncle Ben was as dark as me.
Oh, tell me about it. I'm the darkest in my family, too. My parents were white.
How'd that happen?
I don't wish to talk about it. My mother is dead.
Oh, sorry to hear that.
I have been an orphan now for 15 years.
You divorced your parents.
They're dead to me now.
Sorry for your loss, Simone.
I love to do it.
poetic. Song of Songs, chapter 4, verse 1.
Hair like a flock of goats. Yeah, what are you trying to say, Alan?
It's a man's crown, the perfection of beauty. God shines in glorious radiance.
Oh, she's off again. Come on, girlfriend. Give her a knife.
Well, you're not going to let sister loose on your hair, are you, kitten? Oh, she'll scalp you.
And scalp me? That was years ago.
I remember going into her room with a pair of scissors and cutting her hair when she was asleep and trying to sabotage it. So I just thought, this beautiful hair, and she hated it. And I thought, do you know what? I would give anything to have hair like that. Because mine was just afro. It wasn't curly, it wasn't straight. It was just this big nest that just sat on top of my head.
You crept into my room and cut my hair.
I was bored. It's child abuse. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful.
We can't all be holy rollers like you, Emma. Hey, kitten, you know your hair I cut off?
Yeah.
Well, I kept it months after in my knicker drawer.
You kept my hair in your knicker drawer?
Yeah.
You never guess what I got with me here.
Yeah. I was doing Kitten's hair for tonight. It was my treat doing everyone's hair, especially for tonight. And then you go and buy a load of crappy wigs. It's just a bit of fun. What kind of message are you giving her anyway?
She's always wanted to be blonde.
Emma, I have little mixed race girls coming in here every day wanting to be blonde or white. And it don't mean shit. It just means we're not taught to feel good about ourselves.
Lighten up, sister. It's just a bit of fun.
Oh, right, yeah. Time for the black sheep of the family jokes again now, is it? Oh,
don't go getting all boring.
Oh, you know, just get lost, stupid cow.
Can I join you? She means well.
Well,
I'm sorry.
She's always been so thoughtless, so selfish. I had everything worked out, and then she goes and spoils everything.
She means well, sister.
She's lost the plot this time. Is this about Aaron?
Who?
Her son.
I don't know.
Because when I mentioned him earlier, right, she went all funny. Have they fallen out again?
She's never mentioned him.
I bet that's what it is.
You know, you're right about the wigs. About blonde things.
Oh. I am?
Black girls shouldn't wear blonde wigs.
Exactly.
We should be happy in our own skin, with our own hair, as who we are. As who we are.
Yeah.
When I was at school, the other girls used to call me coconut. You know, brown on the outside, but all white on the inside. Well, just because I couldn't do that Jamaican and my father was African. He wasn't Jamaican. It's not my fault, I'm adopted.
Well, they were just joking about beautiful brown skin.
Ah, my year-round tan.
Yes, exactly.
Shot from the waterproof.
You know, we've got to put Emma right.
Leave it with me. Maybe we could do something together.
Thanks, Simone, for your support. It means a lot.
Nothing.
Okay, do you want a bag?
No, I don't, Simone. Well, I have just one.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Right. I'll tell you one thing for nothing. Mm-hmm. There is no way that Emma is going to get me wearing one of those stupid masks.
I'm not baby.
Oh, you'll always be my baby.
sister. I'm just excited, that's all. Yeah. Blessed is the seat which walketh not. Scornful seat standeth on my head.
Eh?
Ungodly trespasses against my bed.
Anna, are you sure you're all right?
Of course I am. Anyone fancy a topper?
No, thank you.
How's your rash?
I'm okay.
Where's your cream?
And I said, stop pressing, stop pressing, you stupid cow!
Person wouldn't be able to tell.
No, from looking at Beyonce, they wouldn't know
that's not having your hair, not having your hair, not having your hair. My fiance has never seen my natural hair. Ever. Mm-mm. I've forgotten what my natural hair looks like now. It's been so long, really.
It's been so long.
I've moved on. Yeah, that princess is just long gone. I'm posh. I'm not Scary Spice, you know? I'm just me.
I'm just me.
That's why. Honestly, she's been away 5 years. And she comes back 5 minutes and starts telling everyone what to do.
I just care about you, that's all.
You don't know the first thing about me.
If you let me
Our Father, who art in heaven.
Our Father, who art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done.
Thy will be done.
On earth as it is in heaven.
On earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Emma!
What?
Is that what you think?
Is it? It's medicinal.
Champagne out there.
Well, none of us expected you to drink it. It was a joke.
Oh, very funny. Ha ha. Let's laugh at Anna again.
I don't mean that. You okay? I swear to you.
It's so hot tonight.
I just come here to cool off. It's just to help me get through.
For my nerves.
It's just one.
One now and then, you know?
Anna.
Look, the Lord forgives us our trespasses. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Is this about Aaron? Okay, I know it's hard.
So much stuff. I can't hold on to it all.
Yeah, Emma, this don't help.
Oh, sister, I'm more myself. I've had a drink. If I don't drink, it's like I'm not here.
What is going on with you and Aaron? Every time I mention him, you freeze up.
Well, he just won't speak to me because of this. He's washed his hands of me.
I'm sorry.
Oh, sister, honestly, if it hadn't been for Simone, I don't know how I'd have gotten through these last few years.
Well, that's nice. She's clearly a very caring lady.
Oh, she is, sister. I'm so glad you two have finally got to meet. And I'm so glad you're back.
Me too, mate. Have you tried calling Aaron?
Of course I have. He won't return my calls. He won't reply to my texts. It's like I'm not here.
I'm sorry I was so horrible to you.
That's okay. What a family for if not to be rude to each other, eh?
Mm.
Come on. With Aaron, leave it to me. I'll phone him.
You would?
Yeah, I'll phone him right away.
He won't pick up.
No, he will. For his favourite auntie. I promise you. I'll get him for you.
Would you do that for me, sister?
Of course I will. Well, you won't be able to resist me. I promise. I'll sort it.
Oh, sister, thank you so much. I don't know what to say.
You just promise me.
I won't lay you down.
Good.
Don't let me drink any more, sister. Will you help me?
Yes, of course I will, babe. Of course.
I just want him to be proud of me.
I'm proud of you.
Oh, God bless you, sister. Bless you for everything. What would I do without you?
Oh. Okay. Yeah. Oh.
won't. Trust me.
But you can ring him now.
In a minute. Simone, can I have a word?
Yes.
Just take her out. Just give her some water outside. Simone?
Yes, Simone.
Simone, I just wanted to thank you.
What for?
Well, doing such a great job of looking after my sisters while I've been away.
It's nothing.
No. You've clearly done an amazing job. There's any way I can thank you, you know? Free haircut, that sort of thing. Oh, sorry, I forgot. Seriously though, anything at all, you just let me know. Now that I'm back, you'll have a bit more time to yourself, which I'm sure you'll appreciate.
My work here is not yet done.
Sorry?
My work here is not yet done.
I'm back now.
It's an ongoing project. The project of life. You don't just drop in and drop out.
Well, who's dropping in and dropping out?
Oh, there's a lot of processing that needs to be done.
What are you going on about?
Well, as you for a start, but it should help us all out of condition.
Don't touch me!
Angry and congested. I can feel it. You never did physical education at school, did you?
No.
Explains a lot. I can read auras, and yours, bitter, dark, malevolent. Oh, it's congested, it's trying to get out. Sister, you need help.
Bob Marley, did you not hear me? I'm back. So we don't need any of your hippie shit help.
I'm so sorry. Sister, join me in a sun salutation. It will release your energy and help you flow more freely.
Kitten, you better save me from saying so much, your handy bendy friend. I'm going to go call Aaron.
Oh, sweeping. Breathe, breathe, breathe with Simone. Relax, honey. Relax. You're so tense. Breathe, breathe.
If you said no, on you. The man from Del Monte said yes! Woo! Yes! Sister, thank you for Aaron to please come and join us for a drink tonight.
Tomorrow, you're top! It is Kitten's hen party. Men don't come to hen parties.
He's family. It's all right with you, isn't it, Kitten, if Alan comes down tonight?
Yes.
Sister, I don't know how to thank you. Oh, God. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. Let's have a drink to celebrate. I mean, let's have a dance. Mr. DJ, play us a tune!
Ooh, it's really mixed quality on here. But I will do my best.
Right, that's my iPod.
Ooh. Oh. Bonnie Tyler? Ooh, let not you be a Bonnie Tyler
host. Oh, this seems like Stadium Rock!
My goodness me! Tons of you too on here!
Oh, you told me earlier that black people don't like you too.
No, I did.
Yes, you did.
No, I did.
Yes, you did.
You did? You said that Stadium Rock was culturally alien to the black community.
No, I never.
Oh, you did. I have a photographic memory for conversations.
Stop yelling at me. Right.
I don't see black or white. I just see people.
You would say that.
Pardon?
Or nothing.
Oh, it's a good bit coming up.
That is not my music.
It's your iPod, dear. White Snake?
Oh!
Nick Kershaw? My God, it's amazing. shuffle.
Yes,
it's not my music. No hand-eye coordination to it. Ready, love.
Oh, head dot!
Thank you. she always put ribbons in my hair.
But it was almost like, you know, dressing a monkey.
Dressing a monkey.
When I was about 8, my mum gave me up, and she had all my hair cut off.
Put ribbons in my
hair. I was horrified. She said it was the only way. She said it could be controlled.
She used to put it in these hideous bunches because she was white and she didn't know what to do with my difficult hair. So one day I cut those awful bunches and then hid them in my mum's knicker drawer.
Put ribbons in my hair.
She had all my hair cut off. I was horrified. She said it was the only way. She said it could be controlled.
Dressing a monkey.
Dressing a monkey.
Do you like my kente cloth? It has real gold running through it. I wore it in 1984 when I was crowned African Queen at the Maiden Bradley Carnival. Here I am with my entourage. Mr. MacDonald has a newfound respect for me. You can see by his devoted expression in the picture. He even cleaned his teeth for the occasion. My entourage is hairy, but respectful. My expression is cool. Eyes say it all. I am in control. I'm cool. I am the Queen. For 267 days after my coronation, I swept up and down Maiden Bradley High Street in my African cloth. I walked with my head held high. No one could touch me. I told everyone at school I was an African princess. My father was a minor Ashanti chief. I was the heir apparent to a vast fortune in Congolese diamonds. My real parents had entrusted me to an elderly white couple in the West Country. They would come back for me when the war had abated, and at that time, I would claim the throne and the diamonds. I'm in control. I'm cool. I am the Queen. How special. People started picking me for games. Picking me! Boys stopped spitting in my desk and pulling at my hair. I was special. A minor uncle died in Swaziland after a long illness. Thank you, yes. I will go. Thank you. You like me? I will not have anybody telling me what to think and what to say. I will not have anybody. I wear my locks with pride. They will not be cut down. Full stop! I'm an African queen, you see.
Policeman, go slap your face in your guitar. I'm a man, go whip your hair, she go look like donkey. Rhodesia, they do their own, only just they are for nothing. South Africa, they do their own.
Oh!
she went through this phase of thinking that she was the Timothy girl. No, babe, it was before your time.
It was just the phase.
Oh my God, Emma, he used to crack me up in that big white tent dress of she was leaping through the park, big Timothy style, in towels on her head, trying to be the blonde girl of the go and do the thing.
Gosh, I hope the towels were clean.
I can't believe you were out in that dress, Emma.
Until I spilt Vimto on it. Oh. And it went dirty pink. Oh. And Mum threw it away. I think she was secretly relieved. The neighbours thought I'd gone loopy.
Can we eat now, Emma? Bloody hell, I'm starving.
Vimto first.
Emma,
over then move. We need it for the family album. To capture the moment.
That's my wig. You don't need your wig.
Yes, I do. Masks, everyone.
Okay.
Get your masks.
Put mine on.
Thank you.
Put your wig on. Big mask on.
Yeah.
All right.
Sister. What?
I've only got Beyonce.
No.
Left.
This is fine. Come on.
Suits you.
Cheese.
Fromage.
Oh,
what do we look like?
All right, now you love it. Now can we eat, Emma?
Yep.
Right, order what you want. It's on me.
Oh, I really fancy the sweet sour pork. You know the one with the pink sauce that glues your mouth together. Oh, not spicy, Emma, and don't forget vegetarian.
You're a vegetarian.
Of course.
Now, why don't that surprise me?
I can't eat hot food either, or onions, or green peppers, or shellfish, or shiitake mushrooms.
Bloody hell. What can you eat?
I just like to be careful about what I eat.
Let's stop recording all them food programmes, Lyra.
What programmes?
You know, Rick's Fishy Wishy This, and Jamie's Big Wendy House That. That's all you used to do 5 years ago. Then you go back to eating the same old crap week in, week out.
I just like to record food programmes. They give me ideas.
Oh, is it some salmon fish cakes on Friday and rice and peas on Sunday?
Well,
there's nothing wrong with a bit of ritual.
Should we share some rice?
No, I don't like rice.
How can you not like rice?
Just don't.
Sorry.
Why don't we just get a bit of everything with extra noodles?
Why don't we have a set menu?
So one without chilli or green peppers or shiitake mushrooms. And with sweet and sour sauce and no rice.
Oh, bingo! Ding dong! Menu G. And it's got veggie options.
Okay, fine by me.
Okay. Menu G is...
All right, let's go for that.
Menu G. Menu G. Menu G. What's this about rice? Oh, I'm so sorry. Slipped my mind. Look, we'll do a session on this next week, okay? Remember, I'm here for both of you always. Always. Let's have a family hug. Oh, love you both.
Oh, right, all done.
It was necessary.
I ain't talking to you, Bob Marley. Emma, what do you think you're playing at? You defaced a family photo.
I didn't want any photos of him.
Why?
You know why.
Oh, too dark for you, is it?
Stupid.
You're just as bad as mine.
Oh, Mum wasn't that bothered when she went into bed with him.
Don't start that again, man.
That man, he ruined our family.
What? It was Christmas. They were pissed. No big deal.
Oh,
care about our mother. It takes two, you know, Emma.
Uncle Ben was a randy old goat. I never liked the way he looked at you like he was undressing you with his eyes.
Excuse me.
You see, you've upset Kitten.
Well, I didn't start this.
I'll see if she's okay.
No. She's my sister.
Oh, our broken record.
It's your own family. Silk. Liquid honey. Before he did what he did, run his fingers through my curls. Before he did what he did. And that is why I don't want my curls, sister. Because of what he did.
Saying.
3 years ago, Emma, she found out about what he did, and she fell apart, and then the drinking, and Aaron, and everything just fell apart, and it was all my fault. Simone's help.
Simone?
I could never have faced any of this without Simone.
What's Simone done then?
She's been amazing, sister. She helped me understand what that man did. And it wasn't my fault. We talked for hours. We've even had family sessions with Anna and everything. She's a fantastic therapist, you know?
Kitten, are you sure about this?
What do you mean?
Simone, she qualified in this sort of thing.
What's that got to do with
it? I'm just saying. You need proper help with stuff like this, otherwise there's a danger.
No.
Sometimes things can get mixed in your head. I mean, I know Uncle Ben, he was a bit of a ladies' man.
So you love us, legally?
No, of course I do. Just saying, be careful. You know, sometimes your memory can play tricks on you.
Sister, are you saying that you don't believe me?
No.
Then what are you saying?
Just saying, get professional help, Kitten. Do not believe what some crackpot hippie
woman tells you. Sister, you either believe me or you don't. You're either with me or you're not.
Gelatinators. Just sitting here, I ain't saying much, I just think. And my eyes don't move, left or right, they just think. I'm fit to be, and I'm fit to look. Plus I think I'm getting weak, cause my foot's are too still. I'm just sitting here, I ain't saying much, I just gaze. I'm looking into space where my CD plays. I'm just gaze quite good, in fact I gaze all day. And if I live, then I just gaze when I gaze.
Sends her love. Alright, I've got to go now.
All right, my love. You take care. Bye-bye.
You wanted it, so I fixed it for you, and this is how you repay me.
I'm so sorry. I couldn't save him. Not like this.
Emma, it's up to you. Up to you when you want to see him. Nobody else, just you. Here, take them.
What do you care?
How is she?
As you'd expect. She's traumatized. She's lying down.
Can I do anything?
Oh, you've done enough damage already.
Hey, Kitten. How about we go through your wedding plans and I'm finished tidying up? Kitten? We can now what? I said, we can decide about your hair for the wedding. We've got loads of ideas.
No, you're not going anywhere near my hair.
Not after what you did to Simone.
Kitten! Well, don't get it twisted, man.
You always have to be right, don't you?
But I was right.
It doesn't matter what anyone else thinks or feels. Sister always has to be right.
But I wasn't right.
All that I haven't cut my hair since 1992. It's bullshit.
Nothing matters as long as you get what you want and you get your own way.
I was right. You and Emma, you should listen to me about her. She's poison. How can you trust someone that lies like that?
I am with you. I don't want you taken in by some crazy woman that's filling your head with all sorts about our family. She's not even family.
She's a better sister than you've ever been.
Oh, really?
You're just jealous.
Oh, what? Of some bar-leg sadder? I don't think so. Do you know what? I've never liked you doing my hair. Ever. Even when I was a little kid, I hated it. You were really rough. I just went along with it to please you. In fact, you can do whatever you want off my wig. Just don't come anywhere near me or my hair.
I've finished the interview now. Is there anything you want to tell me that I haven't asked you or you think I might be interested in?
It's absolutely lovely of you all to show such concern. But please don't worry. I'm fine. All that coconut Brillo pad business, it's all part of the show. I don't let any of that bother me. It's somebody else's crap, and I killed her years ago. So please don't worry yourselves about me.
When I was about 8, my mum gave me up, and she had all my hair cut off. I was horrified. She said it was the only way. She said it could be controlled.
Dressing a monkey.
I just see people. And remember, I am here for you all. Always. Always. Later.